Let's compare these three small paintings. The painting, View of Indian Bar Cove, Brooksville, Maine, was painted by Fitz Henry Lane in 1850. Lane is famous for his paintings of the seashore near Gloucester, Massachusetts. The painting, Pulpit Rocks Gloucester, October, was painted by Lane's student and collaborator, Mary Blood Mellen, about whom we know very little. Now look at the third painting in this arrangement, Coming Ashore near Brace's Rock, Gloucester, Massachusetts. It is credited to Lane, but there is no signature. Many art historians believe this work was painted by Mellen or was perhaps created collaboratively between the two friends. Compare the rocks in this painting to those in Mellen's painting. Do they seem similar in their shape and coloration? Look at the figure in each painting. Do they resemble each other? Look at the way the ocean is painted, particularly the ripples in the water. Do they look more like the water in Lane's painting or the water in Mellen's painting? Lastly, does the general coloring of the painting in the center, particularly the use of pinks and yellows, more closely match Mellen's painting or Lane's? What do you think? Fitz Henry Lane, also known as Fitz Hugh Lane, is sometimes categorized as a member of the Hudson River School, and sometimes categorized as a luminous painter. But he was above all a quintessential New Englander. He was deeply influenced by the thinking of friends like Henry David Thoreau and Ralph Waldo Emerson, who were leaders of the Transcendentalist movement in Boston. Transcendentalism held that nature provided a link to the spiritual world of universal mind. Lane's paintings often move beyond painting the real to painting the ideal. Mary Blood Mellen was Lane's student and friend. Lane had Mellen copy his work for practice, and during her apprenticeship, they collaborated on many canvases. Several examples of such collaborations have come to light in the last decade, including, possibly, Coming Ashore near Brace's Rock, Gloucester, Massachusetts. Although women were educated in the arts in the 19th century, being a professional artist was the domain of men. Most art academies didn't admit women, and neither did the clubs that linked artists with patrons. The important figure drawing classes, which featured nude models, were off limits to most women. The fact that this unsigned painting was attributed to Lane may be a result of this historical bias against women.